Skinner, during your presentation at SIAB 2015, you said that if banks keep doing what they are doing today, they are going to die sooner or later. What do you imagine as the future of bank?
Well, banks are not going to die, but they will if they don't change, because they were all built in the last century for dealing with paper documentation in a localized network called the branch. And that's completely changed because we now deal with technology and the digital distribution of data through the globalized network of the internet. So the branch structure, the buildings and human structure of the banking system of the last century isn't fit for this century. And what all the banks are trying to do is say, we have to take the physical foundations that we've layered digital on top of and reverse this into digital foundations with physical on top. And that is a massive change program and a massive change of thinking. And all the banks in the world, particularly those here in Brazil, are challenged with how to achieve this.
And what are going to happen while banks are moving into this digital area, world?
Well, the banks are going to find that they have to really understand what digital means. And most banks think it's called a channel, and it's just like mobile and internet and call centers, something they add onto their old systems. The ones that really understand this have a different view. They have a culture where the whole bank thinks about a digital foundation and how to leverage that to their customers' advantage. So what we're really seeing is banks trying to work out how to adapt not just their systems and technologies, but their people and their culture to incorporate digital into the mindset of the bank. And that's a slow process, but it's the one that has to be led from the top by the chief executive and the executive team.
Another thing that was really under discussion here at SIAB was the customer experience in the digital era. What is your advice to financial institutions regarding this? Because they are trying to make this move and trying to incorporate social media and everything. But what we are seeing is much more an interaction from marketing perspective than doing effectively something that will embrace or enhance customer experience.
Well, in the digital age, we're talking about simplicity and a great user experience and removing all the complexity of banking. And going back to my earlier comment around complexity, that really is derived from the fact that the banks had this complex structure based on physical distribution. Now, in the old world, they controlled all of that distribution of the financial service and the customer experience. Now they're seeing new companies like Uber, Airbnb, the Googles, Amazons of this world creating fantastic digital user experiences in all the ways they access those companies. And banks have realized that because they're just bits and bytes of data themselves, money is just data, they have to compete with those guys. So a great user experience, simplified, removing all the complexity, is one of the other big challenges that the banks are facing, which is why you're hearing all about that at SIAB this year.
And we are moving to the meta coins or bitcoins. How do you think banks will face it? Are they going to embrace this into their own strategy, or they are going to compete with bitcoins or meta coins?
Well, all the banks are actually now looking at Bitcoin and the metacoin, if you want to call it, technologies, and saying, how do we incorporate this technology into what we do? Because what the technology of the Bitcoin protocol has provided is a general ledger system on the internet that's trusted and proven, called the blockchain. And that particular technology allows you to transact anything, anywhere, with anyone around the world, directly, person to person, in real time, for almost free. So the banks are all saying that's actually quite a fantastic thing, because we should be able to use this to get rid of all of our high cost structures and start to actually transact globally between customers and between businesses for almost free, immediately, in real time. Now, when I say that, you think about what we do today. We deal with moving money abroad from Brazil to London, for example, and that's taking days, even weeks. It shouldn't, because if a phone call took a day or a week to get picked up, you'd just hang up. And that's really why we are not in the right state today with our transmitting of money, and the blockchain solves that problem. So the Bitcoin, the Metacoin, the whole movement of this technology is all really focused around this general ledger system of the blockchain. And every single bank, including all those in Brazil, I guarantee, are trying to work out how they can build that into their new systems.
And also the competition in the near future, the competition comes from companies that are not specifically financial institutions, come from telecommunication operators doing mobile payments or mobile transactions and other tech companies. How these all ecosystems will work together?
That's one of the points I was making in my presentation here at CIAB, is that there is a new market that's being created called FinTech, finance and technology that's integrated. So historically, banking has been using technology. Now they're actually finding that the technology is integrated into what the customer's actually seeing. But in that process, there's a whole raft of new companies that are creating very specialist FinTech capabilities around payments and lending, credit, mortgages, commercial, corporate banking, investment markets, everywhere. In fact, there's over 1,000 of these new fintech startup companies that have seen last year, 2014, $13.2 billion of investment from venture capitalists. The year before, $4 billion. The year before that, less than $1 billion. It's growing every year. This year, about $30 billion. In 2015. So with these new companies are actually taking away a lot of the core market of banking. Goldman Sachs estimate they'll take 20% of bank profits over the next 5 years. That's seriously challenging the whole structure of the industry. So fintech is the hot space, and if banks don't change to be digital, then that's the reason they'll die, because these guys will take over.